my experience, also a major stressful event in the productive life of a beef animal, which is those that are arriving in the feed yard. If you think about the U.S. beef industry and many other industries across the planet, then you have the situation where calves are arriving in commercial feed yards, and the feed yard has no history of where those calves came from. They were probably transported for 12, 16, sometimes 24 hours on a truck. As soon as they arrive in the feed yard, you know, some of them were weaned the day before, so you have the stress of weaning, you have the transportation, you have that stress of the auction yard as well. And then arriving in the feed yard, you have this new environment that the animal is completely unaware of. New diets, commingling with cattle from different sources. So it's a mixture of stressors have a very detrimental effect on the immune system and also productivity of those animals within the first 2 months in the feed yard. That's why we see so much bovine respiratory disease in those that we call high-risk cattle. The excess of stress, the accumulation of stressors, really bring down the animal's immunocompetence, and then gives the chance for those respiratory pathogens to cause the disease. And it's normal for high-risk receiving cattle to experience about 50 or 60% incidence of BRD. So that was the second low-hanging fruit. Apply the analog in cattle arriving feed yards, high stress receiving cattle. That's what we did, two or three projects with the analog of the bovine appeasing pheromone being applied at arrival. Again, high-risk cattle. We didn't know the source. They were transported for 12, 16, 20 hours, arriving in the feed yard. First processing, as soon as they arrived, we applied the analog. And on those studies, what we saw was, again, about 20% increase in average daily gain. And that increase in average daily gain was caused by an increase in feed efficiency, which is a result from the less stress or physiological stress that those animals experienced after feedlot arrival. We also saw some benefits to the immune system. Animals required less BRD treatments in terms of a recovery from BRD. So they were more immunocompetent and responsive to the BRD treatment. In some cases, we saw increases in feed intake as well, because less stress means more appetite, which translates into more average daily gain. The next step that we took was, all right, if you apply the analog at feedlot arrival, we're still missing that window of stress prior to arrival, which is the whole transportation period, okay? So if the animal's in the truck for 12 hours, 18 hours, 24 hours, that's a highly stressful situation. And if you apply the analog after arrival, you're missing those 24 hours of stress. So we ran another study where we applied the analog at loading, okay, before transportation to the feed yard, loading at the ranch of origin. And if you apply before the stress of transport, your gain in terms of average daily gain jumps from 20% to 30%. So if you apply right before the animal is exposed to that stressful management, okay, then you have an additional gain in terms of the response in production from those animals receiving the analog. It's important to say that the studies that we did show that the analog works for about 15 days. When you apply to the animal, it's probably working for about 15 days, stays in the animal's skin for about 15 days. So in any stressful situations that those animals encounter, within 15 days after application, the analog still works. So it has a 15-day working period. Now, in animals that you know are going to be exposed to another stressful situation, then you have to reapply after 15 days, so you cover that animal throughout that entire stress period. So if you're selling your cattle, let the buyer know that you're using this technology, because the buyer is going to be the one that's going to receive all the benefits. Now, if you're buying cattle, I would incentive you to communicate with the seller to apply the analog prior to transportation, because that's going to be a good investment from the buyer side. So communication is essential, which is something that we unfortunately don't have a lot in our industry. And for adoption of technologies and for return on investment, communication is essential.